You were truly madly deeply into Australian pop duo Savage Garden in the 90s. You are in for a treat.
So after more than a decade away from the spotlight, lead singer Darren Hayes is back touring the UK, performing classic hits as well as some new music. Have a listen.
So I'm just really enjoying Darren on the sofa here because he's come in like looking fabulous in this lovely glittery suit, which is great.
Thank you.
And we've just so I appreciated that, and then you appreciated my eyeshadow.
It's very good.
Well, it was put on me, but thank you very much.
Well, it's very purple.
Anything about Charlie you'd like to?
Great hair.
Don't really have to.
No, great hair. If I can have hair like this, well, I think we might be the same age. Actually, I'm 50, so.
I know. Well, we're not the same age.
Really?
No, we're not. Okay. Not quite. But what was going on in the... Were you in the bath singing?
Oh, my gosh. Did they film me in the bath and me not know?
Yes. No, yes, yes, you were.
Yeah, I was.
Oh, what was going on there then?
To be honest...
Was there water in the bath? Was it a fake bath?
No, it was a real
really?
Bath. And I was freezing. Yeah, I was freezing. They tried to heat it on set, but it didn't work. And it was about a 12-hour shoot. So I had to pretend not to be shivering, and it's really difficult to do.
So were you singing or you miming? I shouldn't say ask these things. Really,
you can, video shoots, because, you know, I'm old school, I always sing in music videos.
Oh, so. Now we've got the fools. Now you have got water in the bath.
Yes, yeah.
And petals and fish, apparently.
Yeah, I didn't actually realise we were shooting music video. I was just at home, and my team just said, you know what, let's just save some money and get a camera out. No, seriously, that was actually a very emotional, it's a very emotional song. And, but it was a fun music video to make, apart from being freezing most of the time.
Yeah. Why was the song emotional for you?
Well, it's a song about mental health. And I am someone who, I talk about this very openly and very honestly. For about 25 years of my life, I've lived, and I say I thrive with it, but I've lived with a mental health diagnosis. I have a major depressive disorder, which in my business is sort of not uncommon, but I was lucky that I was diagnosed right at the peak of the Savage Garden career. And so it's been a challenge. So this song is about, you know, living with depression and accepting the fact that I call the song Poison Blood because I say it's a blessing, a gift and a curse, but every day is a decision to stay with my poison blood.
Do you think the music industry is good or bad or better now for those people with mental health diagnoses?
Only recently better. That's a great question. I think if we look at some of these young stars, I mean, we all grew up obviously in an era where there were those tragic rock and roll stories of stars who sort of over-medicated and had to self-soothe. And then there was that period in the 90s where we mocked people like Britney Spears, who now I think we're all quite embarrassed by the way we didn't understand that was an artist who was really just going through a mental health crisis. Now I think we're so much more literate about that in every field. We really understand when it comes to women, in terms of postpartum depression, we really accept that this is just a very real process that women go through. I think with men, we're becoming more literate about that, where the stigma of men talking about emotions is slowly erasing. But when we talk about someone like me, I'm a gay man, so when you talk about the LGBTQI community, the level of, sadly, of suicide amongst people you know, who are queer used to be, and still continues to be, I guess, so high.
And you didn't start your career as an out gay man.
No, I was married to a woman.
Yeah, yeah, and that in itself adds to the pressure.
Yes.
Of one identity, mm-hmm. coping, who are your confidants, where's your support coming from?
Yeah. I mean, it's funny, we're on morning TV and I'm very happy and I'm so grateful to be here. But the truth is, you know, I came from a family where my father was an alcoholic and he was very violent. And I think, like a lot of pop stars, I describe this as I had this God-shaped hole in me. And, you know, Bono would say this, Madonna has often said this with the loss of her mother. But that was this instigating moment for me where I thought, well, if I can make the world love me, maybe this can fix this thing that's wrong with me. But at the same time, I was also a young, sensitive child who was gay but didn't realize that. And everyone told me that I was gay before I realized that. And I used to just think, why does everyone think I'm gay? You know, I was on Top of the Pops, I was on all these TV shows, and expressing this other part of me so beautifully because it was so repressed within me because of all of those early childhood years of shame. And that led to a lot of that depression.
I tell you what, for someone, as I understand it, you sort of stepped aside for five years, yes, or so, from certainly from the business world.
10 years.
10 years? Mm-hmm.
Yes.
For someone who's done that, it feels like you've come back kind of... I mean, you're telling really interesting insights into your life. Do you feel like now you've got a whole new story to tell? Is that part of the inspiration, stepping away, coming back?
Very much so. I think I understood that I was burnt out, and that's part of that self-care thing. You know, I'm lucky that I've been married for 17 years to my husband, and that in itself was a really beautiful thing for me. I think in this country, we had a civil partnership, which did so much for my self-esteem and my self-love for myself, you know, as a gay man. And when I was 40, I stepped away because I'd been doing this since I was 13 when I decided I was going to become a pop star. So those 10 years aside gave me life experiences. And I remember seeing Kate Bush in concert at Shepherd's Bush. And I cried when she sang Hounds of Love because I never thought I'd see that again. And I had this epiphany and I thought, if I don't come back and sing these Savage Garden songs, who will? And that was a really beautiful moment for me because I realised I'm part of a musical legacy.
Well, the answer to that is probably some dreadful karaoke act in a pub somewhere, isn't it?
Which is sometimes me when I'm in Las Vegas, if I'm honest. But
do you do your own songs in karaoke?
If my friends make me, yes. Yes, of course.
And then you have people say, he's rubbish, that guy doing this.
Yeah, he's nowhere as good as the
which
original.
Which is devastating, yes. But yeah, sometimes that can happen, yeah.
It's been lovely talking to you.
You too.
Very nice.
And keep working on the sarcasm now you're back in the UK.
Thanks, I will, yeah. I've missed it. Living in the US, they don't quite understand what that means, but thank you.
It's a joyful thing. It's a joyful thing.
UK tour beginning in March.
Yes, March and April next year. Tickets are on sale today. I'm very excited.
Enjoy it.
Thank you.
Darren Hayes,
thanks for having me.